Hey, what's up? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to walk through a wall using Adobe After Effects. And we're also going to see a few tips and tricks on how to improve that look and make it look even cooler. For this video, I'm going to be using the Acer Concept D7 Diesel. It's incredibly fast and it makes running Adobe After Effects like a breeze. This is especially due to the Xeon processor and also the Quadro RTX 5000 graphics card, which is an industry standard and high-end graphics card for, yeah, very serious work. If you want to follow along with the exact same footage as me, you will find that with the link in the description below. We're going to use this footage right here and bring that into a new composition in Adobe After Effects. The first thing that I want to do, you can see myself standing here against the wall and I'm walking away. So what I wanna do is I wanna start rotoscoping myself out of this shot. So I'm going to hold Ctrl and press D on the keyboard to duplicate my footage. And then I want to double click on that layer to open it up. You will get a warning here that the resolution should be on full. So I will go back to my composition here and set the resolution to full resolution just before we start rotoscoping. So I'm going to double click again. So now I want to concentrate myself on the roto. And for that, this laptop is actually really amazing because here on the side, we can see that we have this little pen that I can take out. And the fun thing is that I can also bend my monitor completely so I can customize it completely to my preferences and my type of work that I'm currently doing. Like right now, it's an ordinary laptop, but if I want, I can flip the screen completely towards my audience. Let's say I want to show something to a client, or I can just close it from here and use it as a touchscreen laptop. But what I will do is I will go in halfway and turn it a little bit to myself so I can see what I'm doing and I can easily paint my roto, but I still have access to all my buttons under my laptop. And then I will start my roto. So I will go to my roto brush tool here and I will zoom in just a little bit and place it over here and then start painting myself out here. There we go, then hold Alt to delete any unwanted areas and just try to match your first key as clean as possible. So you really take care of your first frame when you're masking. Make sure you're on the first frame as well. And then after that we can, well, it will go better smooth. So once we have this, we can now start playing our video to check if we have any errors in our mask or over time. So I'm going to start playing this. Hey! So let's say that right here we would actually get back to our original position. We can actually stop the roto or just let it go through the entire timeline, but just so you understand, you don't really need to do the entire roto. You just need to do it for the moment that you're coming out of the wall. So I'm going to stop my roto here and I will press the freeze button because I already had a pretty solid roto and it doesn't need to be perfect anyway. So I'm going to click this button right here. That's going to freeze my roto. It's just going to speed up the entire process. Also, something that I really like to do is when you're done rotoing is rendering that layer out with a transparent background without the roto effect anymore applied to it and then just re-import it to Adobe After Effects. That's just going to make everything run a lot faster while you're working on stuff. For this case, I'm not going to be doing that just because the specs of this computer allow me to work super fast no matter what. So I don't really need to bake anything out here. All right, so our freeze is now done. So we can concentrate back on other stuff. I'm going to revert my monitor just back to a normal laptop. So go back and what I wanna do is call this layer, my roto layer. And basically I want to fill in the background first. So let's see if we can do that. I'm going all the way at the end of my clip and I'm going to duplicate my footage, then right click on my footage and go to time, freeze the frame. Then I will rename this clean wall. And so now I want to remove myself from the background. To do that, I'm going to use my pen tool here and just create a rough mask around myself. And go for none. Open up the mask options here and create a keyframe for the mask path. And then move a few frames forward until I'm completely like out of the wall. It should be around here. And then move the mask again over myself and just control every keyframe in between that to make sure that the mask covers myself up completely for the entire duration here. By the way, if you don't enjoy the color of your mask or it's really hard to see it, you can always click here on the color of the mask and just make it more intense. And there we go. So now we can easily see our mask. I'm going to go over here and split my layer. And now on the first part, I just want to click here on my mask and set it to subtract. Solo this layer for now. And I'm just going to head over to the tracking tab, or the content aware fill tab rather, and then just click here on fill method object and generate fill layer. That will generate this fill layer, as you can see here, and now I'm disappeared for the entire duration of this video. So I'm going to bring this on top of my original footage, and I'm going to disable it for now, and I'm just going to look at my footage and look at my act. Okay, so I'm walking through the wall, I get out, and I think around here I'm actually out of the wall, so I'm just going to cut my freeze frame here towards the end, so you don't see me. Then I will get through the lens and then I want it to find myself back. So I'm going to press T on the keyboard, click on the stopwatch, go till the end of your video and then set it to zero. And then I want to just make our original footage longer. And now you will just transition into my original footage. The reason I'm doing that is this is always going to look cleaner than my roto. Now let's concentrate on the roto, which now you can see that we have a layer with still me here, but we want to maybe, for example, trim it until where I start my act. Like right here. And so as my hand here is currently in the foreground, what I also want to do is first animate my hand. So I'm going to duplicate this for now and put this on top of my roto. This is my original clip. I'm also going to double click on the mask and just delete that. And then rename this arm roto. Double click on that footage, it go to the beginning of the timeline, and you can zoom in here. And use your roto brush tool just on the forearm and my hand here. So I just want this part here to be rotoed. And if I play this, it should already give me a clean track again. I don't need to go through the entire hassle of doing everything. So until here, it's more than enough. I can trim this layer all the way until here and then freeze this layer as well. Okay, so now that we have done our arm roto, I'm just going to uncheck all these solos and I'm just going to solo or concentrate on the arm. And I want to right click here and create a new solid layer, which is going to be my mask for the arm. So this is going to be my alpha mat. I'm going to place that on top of that layer and just trim it to the same duration of the arm. Then I'm going to set this, press F4 on the keyboard if you don't see the track matte, and set the arm roto to be alpha matte. So currently we can see it because we have an entire solid here, but we see that the act starts around here. So what I want to do is use my pen tool and just draw a little mask here, just like this, and then press F on the keyboard and set it to subtract and set it to something like 4. So we have a little bit of a feather, but not too much, or like even, let's go for like 10. And so now we have our hand coming out of nothing like this. And so here we can see it looks great, but we have a problem in the beginning. So we're going to create a keyframe for the mask path, go all the way till the beginning or where we see this issue. And then here we can just push this up a little bit. So we are coming through the wall like this and it's growing like that. And so we wait until we have the entire arm. And then after that, I also want to concentrate on the roto so we can create a new solid layer. And this is going to be my mask for the body. We want to create more masks. So we're going to place this solid layer on top of the roto for the body. And we're also going to say alpha matte. So now we should be able to see the roto if we also solo this. And I do want to look at the roto of the arm here so I can see where it's actually growing. So it's growing here, and I like, let's say starting from here, I also want the rest of the body to come in. So I want my face to come in display right here. I also want my body to come in display, and I also want my knee to come in display, which is right here. Then press M twice on the keyboard. Do that again, M twice on the keyboard. And now you should see all the options for the masks. I'm going to click on the mask path to create a keyframe for that. We never know if we want to animate this. And then for the feather, I'm going to just hold shift and select all of these feathers and just increase this to something like 40 or 30, something that you like. And then we also want to select all of the expansions and go a little bit back and create a keyframe for the expansion and maybe push these back into space or back into the time and then push them out until I'm fully revealed like here and then bring these further into time near the end of the animation. And so if we're now going to look, these masks are going to grow and they're going to show what's underneath that layer after. So you can see now that my entire body is like growing through something, and that through something is the wall. So this looks great. Obviously you can tweak this and make this more perfect as you want. I'm playing with the mask and just thinking of how you would come through the wall as a real depth object. For example, if you come head first, you will first see this part of your head coming through and then the rest of your body. So try to think in depth what is coming through the wall first. I'm not going to get into detail here because yeah, that's just up to you. But now we get something like that. And that looks already pretty cool, but I'd want to add a few more things and add some distortion. So for the distortion, I'm going to add a new adjustment layer. I'm going to call this distort. And I'm going to add here a wave distortion, or actually what I want is ripple. So I'm going effect, distort, ripple. Okay, then place the ripple at those points of impact. So you can place one, for example, at the hand that is coming through and then just animate this to react to the hand. So right here, let's just make the radius a little bit bigger so we can see what we're doing. And right here, I'm going to create a keyframe and set the radius to something like 10. And then set the center point to be where the hand is coming through. And then go back in time and set the radius to 0. And like also hold Alt and click on the stopwatch for the ripple face. And we can also hit time times something like 150. And so now if we're going to play this, we get an animating ripple that is distorting my hand through the wall. Okay, so that looks cool. Now we can also duplicate this ripple and then offset these keyframes. So I'm going to press U on the keyboard, and for ripple 2, I'm going to select all of these keyframes and just offset them to happen right after the other one. And then here I'm going to place the center point to be on the knee, for example. So we have one starting here. We can duplicate it one more time. Press U on the keyboard, then offset it even more. And then place this one, for example, where the head is going to come through. And like that, you're adding different reaction points for this ripple distortion. And then one more thing that I've done is I've also duplicated my original fill layer where I'm not seen and placed that all the way on top. And then I went to the moment when I start coming through this wall and I also masked out a part a little bit where I'm coming through, like so. And then I added a tint effect to this layer. So I will go over to effects, tint, and then also an invert. And there we go. And then it levels. And then play with these levels until you get like white creaks and black bricks. Somewhat like this. And then you can press F on the keyboard to feather this quite a bit. And what I've done here is I'm going to just delete the mask for now. The reason being is when you solo this fill layer, it will only fill the part that was the mask. So we need to duplicate our original footage as well. Place that also on top together with the fill. just control that I duplicated it, okay. Then unsolder this and then shift, select both of these and then hold control shift C to pre-compose this. And this is going to be my footage with my removed stuff. So I'm going to click okay, just footage, doesn't matter. Then go into the footage and copy all of the effects that I applied to the fill layer, control X to cut them away. Go back to our main composition by clicking here and then pasting that onto the footage, and now we will have that on the entire thing. So that's what we wanted actually. And then I'm going to mask this part out, so like this, and go to a moment when I start coming through the wall. I'm going to set the blending mode to be a screen. I'm going to press F on the keyboard to feather now my mask like I want it to. And now I want to add another tint effect on that footage, and this time it's going to be to color my footage. So double click on that and turn it blue. There we go. And now we can also add the perfect glow effect here, which is a preset that you can download for free on our website. But it's a really powerful preset to give yourself a really nice glowy look. And so if we increase the intensity here and also increase this here, or just play around a little bit, you can also play with the mask here and just push this a little bit more up to space. So we only have these bricks here, but now it's like I'm really coming through the wall here, and yeah, that there are some like magical powers enforcing this. I'm going to press T on the keyboard and play with the opacity now. So right here, I'm going to set it to 100, back right here, set it to 0, and then right here all the way at the end, I'm also going to set it to 0, and then I'm also going to check that if I press M on the keyboard, that I'm going to play with the mask expansion here. So right here, it should be pretty small. And so if you want a more intense glow, you can just go to the color of the last tint and just bring it more towards a white color, and or play with the exposure tag as well. And then one more thing that you can do is use another adjustment layer. And on this adjustment layer, I also used a displacement map called the displacement map. So I'm going to apply the displacement map here on the adjustment layer. And for the displacement map, I'm going to use that footage layer also to displace it. And so now we can start seeing some displacement bricks into my body. So if you look carefully, it distorts a little bit more precisely according to the bricks. So I'm going to click here on that and animate those as well. There we go. Once we have done that, should be more than enough. And all we need to do now is also add a feather here. So also use the ellipse tool for the adjustment layer and just make it a little bit bigger like that. And then press F on the keyboard and also play a little bit with the feather for those layers. And then one more last thing that we need to do is just make sure that the ripple effect also lowers in radius here when it's gone. So set this to 0 here, 0, 0. So we always have like an animation right here, 0, value, and 0. So we just animate it on and off. That's all we need to do. And just one more thing that I wanted to do is bring this footage layer just below my roto. For example, if you want a different glow, you can go ahead and change that here. And then right here, we have a variation. Play around with all these settings. It's really going to be playing around. All right, so now that we have all of these techniques down, all you need to do is tweak them here and there, play around with all the values until you find something that works. And that brings us to the final result right here. Alright, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a like. Also be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell to stay notified when we upload new videos. Apart from that, I'm going to leave you with another video of mine right here, and I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, create epic videos.